Good morning, children. Today I am going to start second chapter, inverse trigonometric function. So as you know that inverse functions are, what are the inverse function? The last time I was explained what are the function. So you see that inverse functions are only if a function is 1-1 onto, that is known as inverse functions. Suppose the set A is related to set B by any relation R, and the members of A, B, C and is 1, 2 and 3. So the image of A is 1, image of B is 2, image of C is 3. Then you can write at the reverse relation. So this is your, if fx is equals to f inverse x, this is your inverse function. Now in the trigonometric function, as you know, suppose I take a 1 value, just like a 1 by 2. Suppose this is a sine x. For x here, we'll take out a different values. You know that is quadrant. In this one, A, S, T and C. A for all. In this first quadrant, you know all the trigonometric ratios are positive. Second one is S for the sine. Sine means it's only sine and its opposite, cosec, is positive. C, T for tan. Tan and its opposite is cot, is positive. C for cos and its opposite is sec, is positive only. So you can say A, S, T, C, add sugar to coffee. Now according to this, you see the value of sine. It is positive in first quadrant. In second quadrant, these two quadrants only. So here 1 by 2, you know for what angle this 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. This is your sine 30. So sine 30 is, means pi by 6. So the first one is pi by 6. When we'll go in the second quadrant, it is 90 plus. This is your 90 here. 90 plus. So 90 means you know that pi by 2 plus theta. That means your cos theta. Here it is given 30 degree, and 90 means 90 plus 30 is 120. You can see the second value also. This is your 1 by 2. So you see the different values here. Sine x is 1 by 2. This is for pi by 6. This is for pi minus pi by 6. This is for 2 pi, pi by 6, 3 pi. All these are this. So for one value of sine, we'll get the different images are there. So you can't say that this is a bijection. It means onto function. That's why you can say this is your many one function. So the many one function is not an inverse function. So you can say when we'll restrict this, it means here you can see that all the trigonometric functions are not an onto function. These are many one function. Now here, if we'll restrict this function, means draw a graph for this, for different values, you know that the maximum value of sine is minus 1, and sorry, the minimum value is this, and maximum value is 1, plus 1 it is. You see this graph here. For pi it is 0, for pi by it is minus 1, this 0, this is pi by 2, this is 1 only, this again 0. So the maximum graph goes, this is minus 1 and this is plus 1. So this is your restricted value. So you can see the trigonometric functions are inverse trigonometric inverse functions are restricted function. Restricted function, because under certain limit you can just find out the inverse function. So next. So see that some inverse functions are given. Sine x under this limit, domains are minus 1 to 1. And this range is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Under this range it is inverse function, otherwise not. Similarly, the cosec one is the same range. Tan is same range. Cosec is, this is 0 to pi. And this is range is, domains are same here, minus 1 to 1. Similarly, the sec and cot also. Now in this one, some relations we'll see. Just like sine inverse x. Just this you learned in previous classes also. This is equals to cosec inverse 1 by x. If you want to convert this in cosec x, so sine inverse x is equals to cosec inverse 1 by x here. Same thing, other values, cos inverse x, this is equals to sec inverse 1 by x. Tan inverse x, this is equal to cot inverse 1 by x, and similarly the other you can change it. Now some other relations, just like a sine of sine inverse x, this is only x, cos inverse cos x, this is also x. Similarly tan inverse tan x, this is also x. Similarly the other trigonometric ratios are there. Now you see some negative one, just like a sine inverse minus x, this value is equals to sine inverse x only, but cos inverse minus x is equals to pi minus cos inverse x. Similarly the tan inverse x, this is equals to tan inverse x only. So here the cos is the negative one, is pi minus cos inverse x. Similarly written here, see this one, sin inverse minus x is minus, is only sin inverse x, cos inverse x is minus this cos inverse x, tan inverse minus is minus tan inverse x, and same thing there other things is given here. Only for cos inverse x minus x is pi minus cos inverse x, sec minus x is pi minus sec inverse x, cot inverse minus x is pi minus cot inverse x, this is. Now one formula here, this sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is pi by 2. So this is true for all the values of x here. How you can prove this one? Suppose we'll take sine inverse x, this is equals to y only. Now remove this inverse function, so you can write here sine x, x equals to sine y. Now this sine y you can easily convert as in terms of cos. So how you can convert? As you know here, this is sine inverse sine square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. From this formula you can change, cos square x is equal to 1 minus sine square x. So same thing here, if this is square given, here not given a square, so change in under root like this here. So under root 1 minus cos square x, cos square y, like this you can see. But here it is given pi by 2, so convert as a pi by 2. This is in complementary form. So you know cos 90 minus theta is pi by 2 minus theta equals to sine theta. So from this you can change here. So this is your cos 90 minus theta means y here only. So you can say x equal to this value. Now cos transfer this side, you can say cos inverse x is pi by 2 minus y. And what is y here? Y already taken, it is sin inverse x. So you can say pi by 2 minus sin inverse x. So transfer this side, so you can say sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. So like this you can, other formula also you can prove. Just like as tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is pi by 2, sec inverse x plus cos x inverse equals to pi by 2, some other things here written here, all this. Now some basic formulas also used for finding here, just like a sin inverse x plus sin inverse y, this is equals to what? So you can see sin inverse here, x under root 1 minus y square plus y under root 1 plus x square. This is the formula for sin inverse x plus sin inverse y. Similarly, the cos one also, cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, this is equals to cos inverse xy minus under root 1 minus x square under root 1 plus x square, these things. So similarly, the tan also, so many other formula you can write down these things. So now how to solve this trigonometric function? Just like all these formula you must prove it. Just like it is given sin square x equals to cos square minus 1, sec square x, this you know, learn in class 10th, all these results. And that sin c plus sin d, sin c minus sin d, all you must learn, already learn in class 11. So how to convert the principal range? Suppose any question is given. This is given how to convert in a principal range. So the principal range of different trigonometric functions are just like you know that this inverse function, sine of inverse function, restricted for the limit minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 under this limit. Suppose here you want to find out the value of sine inverse 2 pi by 3. You want to find out the principal range of this number. So how to convert this? Sine inverse 2 pi by 3 means pi minus pi by 3. You can break this 2 pi by 3 in this form. So you know this pi minus theta. What is this? In the case of supplementary angle, according to this quadrant, you know when the supplementary angles are given, there is no conversion. Sine always in sine, cos always in cos, tan always in tan. But the sine according to this quadrant will change. So 180 minus that, it is in second quadrant here, in this quadrant. So in this quadrant, sine is always positive. So you can say this sine inverse pi by 3. So this is your principal range, or principal value. One is this. Similarly, other one you can find out. With all these values which are within this range, that is the principal value. Okay. Now, how to apply all these formulas? Just like you want to find out sine inverse 1 plus sine inverse 2. How to solve this problem here? So as you know, the formula for sine inverse x plus sine inverse y. What's the formula here? That is sine inverse x under root 1 minus y square plus y under root 1 minus x square. This is the formula for this. So you can put the values here. X means 1 and y is 1 minus 4 it is. Plus, similarly this is y is 2 and under root 1 minus this is 1 square. This is only for example, this becomes 0 here it is. So you can see that sine square is here it is given under root minus 3 left only. Okay, so when we'll take other examples, then we'll get the sufficient value for which you can easily take out the angle. So this is the process by which you can find out all the trigonometric functions. Some other provings also, just like if one trigonometric function you want convert in other trigonometric form, just like how to convert sine inverse x in terms of cos inverse x and tan or other forms like this. So for this, you know, just like a sine x it is given that. So you know how to convert this sine x in terms of cos x. What the formula is? You know this formula here, sine square x plus cos square x always equals to 1. So you can say this cos square x means 1 minus sine square x. In this form you can write. So same thing here in it. You can transfer. Actually the formula is sine inverse x. This is equals to cos inverse under root 1 minus x square. This is the formula here. So in this one, how to prove this formula here? This is sine inverse x. So same process will take. Suppose this sine inverse x, this is equals to y. Suppose it. Now in this one, sine x, that is x is equals to, you can say sine y. Now this sine y, with this formula you can convert. What you can write here? You can write cos, 1 minus cos square y it is. This thing. Now, this is your equals to x in this. Now here we want to prove this formula it is only. So what is here cos y? You can say, x equals to sine y. So this is your under root 1 minus cos square y, like this it is. Now you have put the values. This is your x under root 1 minus cos square y. Now squaring on both the side, that is 1 minus cos square y, and you can say this is cos square y is equal to 1 minus x square. Now we'll take LCM, that is a square root. 1 minus, sorry, this cos, cos y is equals to under root 1 minus x square. Now cos transform that side. So we get y is equals to cos inverse under root 1 minus x square. So what is x? What is y? Y here are taken sine inverse x. So you can see the sine inverse x is equals to cos inverse under root 1 minus x square. So you see once again here sine inverse x, we want to prove this value. Sine inverse x equals to y, then x equals to sine y. This sine y you must just convert in terms of cos. In place of sine y you can write 1 minus cos square y. Now this is equals to x only. So now squaring on both the sides, we'll get x square is equals to 1 minus cos square y. Okay, now we'll write cos square y, the value of cos square y, this transform on that side, x square on this side. So we'll get cos square y is 1 minus x square. Therefore cos y is equals to square root 1 minus x square. And then this cos transform on that side convert as an inverse function. So y is equals to cos inverse under root 1 minus x square. So y is your sine inverse x. So you can see sine inverse x is equals to cos inverse under root 1 minus x square. Similarly, the other t ratios you can convert. And one more process to convert one trigonometric ratio in terms of other trigonometric ratio by triangular process. This is given here, triangular process. This all of you learn in class 9th. What the process is? For any t ratio, you just write down right angle triangle. Draw it, yes. So in this right angle triangle, you know, the opposite to the right angle, the longest side is known as hypotenuse, and other two sides are perpendicular and base according to the given angle. Suppose this is the angle you want to find out. So for this angle, this is your perpendicular and this one is your place, base, and this one is your hypotenuse. Suppose here you want convert sine inverse 1 by 2 in terms of cos. So how to convert it is, say this is equals to theta. It means 1 by 2 equals to sine theta. So we'll get for this theta, sine theta is what? All of you learn already in class 9. Sine means this is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. It means this side and this side given here. So you must write here the perpendicular is 1 and this is given 2. And for this right angle triangle, all of you know how to find out this hypotenuse. The theorem is Pythagoras theorem used here. Hypotenuse square is equals to P square plus B square here. So this is your 1 square plus 2 square. It means 1, and this is your 4. It means 5. So your hypotenuse is equals to under root 5, you can say. So now we put the values. What? You want to find out cos inverse. What you want to find? Cos inverse. So in this sense, you can just convert in cos inverse. That means, how to write for cos? For the same angle theta, when we want to write in cos, so that is base upon hypotenuse. So your hypotenuse has become root 5 and this is given 2. So you can see cos theta is 2 upon root 5. So now this cos theta convert in inverse function. So you can say cos inverse 2 by root 5. So theta is your sine inverse. So you can say sine inverse 1 by 2 is equals to cos inverse 2 by root 5. So like this, you can convert any trigonometric ratio in other form. Just like this, you can change sine inverse x in terms of tan inverse x also. In tan inverse, if you want, convert as a cos or sine. So by this triangle, you can change anyone. You see that one more example. If not taken number, we'll take it only the formula. Then how to find? Suppose you want convert tan inverse x in terms of sine and cos. So what formula use? Suppose this is theta, let here. So put these values here. X is equals to what? Tan theta it is. So x upon 1 is tan theta. So replace your value. Tan theta means always perpendicular upon base. It means this is x and this one is value is 1. Now you just find out its hypotenuse by using Pythagoras theorem. So h square is equals to what? Perpendicular square plus bc square. So in this one, perpendicular is your x square and this is 1. So your hypotenuse is square root 1 plus x square, you can see. So this value is 1 plus x square. Now in this one, you want this tan in terms of sine. So you know the sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So you can see this is what the perpendicular. How to convert this? Perpendicular is x and hypotenuse is this. So you can write here sine theta means x upon what? Under root 1 plus x square. This thing. So for this triangle, value of sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, like this here, x upon under root 1 plus x square. Now this sine theta convert as an inverse function. So you can see the theta is equals to sine inverse x upon under root 1 plus x square. So this, what is theta? Theta is given tan inverse x. So we'll get the value of tan inverse x in terms of sine, this is. So tan inverse x is equals to sine inverse x upon under root 1 plus x square. So like this, you can, any t ratio you can convert in other form. So by this way, you can find out all the results and the question. You can directly apply the formula, you will get the answer. So thank you children, you will do all the problems for this exercise and ask your doubt in next one. Thank you.